This problem is a chemical equilibrium problem, constant volume container, and we start with 5 moles of calcium hydroxide, which is a solid, and we're at 1000 Kelvin. And it shows the reaction where the calcium hydroxide solid dissociates, gives us calcium oxide and water, and it wants us to calculate what's the standard Gibbs free energy change at 1000 Kelvin? And says we consume, this is ideal gas. But also very importantly, it says the two solids do not mix. So calcium oxide is a pure solid phase. Calcium hydroxide is a separate solid phase. So we write the equilibrium constant for the reaction. Since we can calculate the equilibrium constant, then we can calculate delta G from the relationship between the two. The equilibrium constant is going to be the activity of the products, water, calcium oxide, activity of calcium hydroxide. Now, the activity is the ratio of fugacities, fugacity in the system, fugacity of pure material, and the activity of water then would be fugacity of water in the gas phase over fugacity of water standard conditions, which 1 bar ideal gas. And the activity of calcium oxide is the fugacity calcium oxide at pressure to system, total pressure here, 10 bar. Fugacity of calcium oxide, standard condition, 1 bar. And then a similar expression for calcium hydroxide. So notice the things that are important. Because calcium oxide is a pure phase, there's no concentration. Fugacity is a pure component. Fugacity, it's essentially identical to the calcium oxide at 1 bar. Raising the pressure to solid has very little effect. So this number is 1, and likewise this number is essentially 1. And our equilibrium constant, because ideal gas is the fugacity of water in the gas phase, pressure water divided by standard state conditions, where ideal gas pressure 1 bar means fugacity is 1 bar, which means we have 10 bar which is the equilibrium pressure over 1 bar. So our equilibrium constant is 10. Remember, equilibrium constants are dimensionless. So we have the equilibrium constant, then we can relate the equilibrium constant to the change Gibbs free energy at standard conditions at 1000 Kelvin. So this is 10. Our unknown is this Gibbs free energy change, and take the log both sides, minus delta G divided by the gas constant, 8.314 joules mole Kelvin, and we're at 1000 Kelvin. So if we solve this for Gibbs free energy change at 1000 Kelvin, 19,140, which we would write as 19.1 kilojoules per mole, because this was joules per mole. And that's the first part of the problem. The second part says, what's the standard Gibbs free energy change for the reaction at 1200 Kelvin? So for the small temperature change, part B, we're going to assume that delta H is constant, independent of temperature. And for a small temperature change, that's probably a reasonable approximation. And then we're going to use the Van 't Hoff equation, which relates equilibrium constants, so we can get the equilibrium constant at the new condition and then get delta G. Log of K2 over K1 is related to the heat of reaction over the gas constant and 1 over the temperature 2, where we know we're trying to find K2. So log of K2 over 10, that's at 1,000 Kelvin. Heat of reaction is given, the problem is 91 kilojoules per mole. So that's 91,000 joules per mole. The gas constant, again, 8.314 joules per mole Kelvin. Want the value at 1,200 and the equilibrium constant of 10, we know at 1,000. So we can solve this equation for K2. K2 is 62, and again, this has no dimensions. And so the Gibbs free energy change standard conditions, 1200 degrees, is minus RT the log of K2, which is minus the gas constant in joules per mole Kelvin, temperature 1200 Kelvin, and the log of 62. So the Gibbs free energy change standard conditions, minus 41,200 joules per mole, or the Gibbs free energy change standard condition, minus 41.2 kilojoules per mole.